Well, it's an honor to represent the Big Ten as the champion of the conference, and very proud of our team. Also, great respect for Coach Anderson and Wisconsin. To say, you know, I've been asked a lot, did I see this happening? I saw a team that prepared very well and is playing at a very high level right now. A lot of things happened this past week, and there's a family grieving that was a big part of our family, Costa, and we had a prayer and a moment of silence in our locker room for him and his family, and we'll never forget our teammate. And also some injuries from Braxton Miller to Dontre Wilson to JT and other players on our team, that they were here supporting their teammates, and 9 assistant coaches who did a wonderful job, but most importantly, very grateful for this team. I get the coach. These are great guys that come together, and in a tough week, a close team even got closer. So that's it. Thank you.
Questions for Cardale and Michael? Raise your hand. We'll get the mic to you. Start right down here in front.
Cardale, did you kind of play today with a little chip on your shoulder? All week people were kind of calling you a third stringer, which generally has a negative connotation.
I wouldn't say a chip on my shoulder. I played with confidence because of the confidence my teammates had in me, my confidence my coaches had in me, my family, my close friends, and Buckeye Nation. So with a chip on my shoulder, not as much as the confidence that my teammates and my coaches had in myself.
Stay on this side.
Cardale, how much fun was that?
It was very fun going out there, showing everybody what we can do when we all come together as one. Mike said it best, and this is the first time that I think that we played as a 9-unit strong, all the way across from kicking games, offense to defense, and it was just a great game plan executed by the players. So.
Other questions for the student athletes? Go back here.
Michael, for you, just what were you guys feeling on the defensive side of the ball, and what was it like going up against Melvin Gordon tonight?
They've had a really high-powered offense all season. They got a great O-line, and Melvin Gordon's a real deal. He made a lot of plays that there was nowhere to make a play. So I got a lot of respect for that offense. I think we came out with a lot of intensity, a lot of drive. Just Cardale said it, 9 units strong on defense. We've usually had a D-line do well, and then linebackers don't have a good game. Linebackers and DBs do well, and then D-line doesn't have a great game. And this was the first time where everyone did their job and did what was asked of them, and then did as hard as they possibly could. So I think this is a huge victory for us, and just a lot of respect for the offense we went against.
Right out here, left side.
Yes, for Cardale, Ohio State did everything it could do within your power. Will it be difficult to wait till tomorrow to win the Final Four, the college football playoff pairings, or decide? Because that's nothing that you fellas can control.
Right, like you said, that's nothing that we can control. We only can control how we prepare for our next opponent. You know, if it's going into the playoffs or not, you know, that's out of our hands. But hey.
Hold on. We're going right here, then we'll get to you.
I thought he pointed you.
Cardale, what kind of statement do you think you guys made to the selection committee with this win?
It was a huge statement, I think, because, we played a great, great team. You know, the number 2 defense in the country. We put up 52 points on them. Then the best running back in the country, we held them.
Offense,
so,
yeah.
Now I'll go out here to the right.
Yeah, Cardale, you had him on the run, but what did you say at halftime to make sure that, you kept things going? You know, and the other thing, what did you say to Coach Ginn when you saw him?
We knew going into this game we was going against, like I said before, a great team all around. So, I think we had a 31 or 38 point lead going into halftime, but that team didn't win 10 games by just giving up at halftime. that's something that our coaches preached at halftime. We just had to keep going because they have fight. And they just want to keep fighting back, keep fighting back, keep fighting back. And as y'all saw that on the very last drive, they called a timeout. This team will not die. So we just have to, you know, keep our foot on their throat and just keep going.
Is there one or two more maybe for the student athletes?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I talked to Coach again. I've been talking to him a lot this week. Just about staying patient and poised and basically seizing every opportunity for success and just keeping me level-headed. I mean, I would say he knows me best, and he knows, even though I might not show a lot of emotions, he knows how I'm feeling. So, I mean, he did a great job of keeping me level-headed.
Thanks for sticking with me. One more for these guys? Anybody? Okay, thank you, fellas. Good luck. You may go back to the locker room. We'll take questions for Coach Meyer. Start right down here.
Urban, from the time you guys got the news on Braxton to now, can you sort of elaborate on the job Tom's done this year? And under these circumstances of facing this defense, how difficult is it for Cardale and Tom to get ready in just 6 days together?
Well, our strength coach made a point to me, and I made it to the team on many occasions, that Cardale came in when we came in. So he's been in every meeting with our quarterback coach, and Tom Herman's an excellent coach. And he's got his unit the first year was very average. And I talk about, you know, we got a player of the year in the Big Ten, but as a unit, they weren't very strong. You know, we had Kenny Guyton got better, but now it's one of the strongest units on the team. He's done a marvelous job. But Cardale is... you know, he's a veteran player that was immature when he first got on campus and has really matured, and obviously Tom gets a lot of credit for that.
Right here in front.
Coach, same question for you. What statement did you make to the selection committee?
Oh, I hate getting asked that, to be honest with you. I just, you know, I like coaching a team. This is without question the most improved from start to finish team that I've ever been around. Because to see him operate and all facets of the game at a high level, from our punter to just the way we played defense today, and then offense was incredible. A third quarterback, two Heisman candidates out, and this guy comes in and plays like that. So, you know, the selection committee has a tough job. And, you know, I guess the whole BCS thing was this was supposed to clean up the BCS conflict or conversations. All I can speak to is I've been around teams that have competed and won national championships, and this team, the way it's playing right now, is one of the top teams in America.
On the right.
Coach, could you talk about your defense and how you thought they played today?
Yeah, best effort we've had since we've been here. I think Mike said it best, that there's always been games where the D-line played well, and maybe the back end was giving up some plays. This is complete, thorough effort by our defense, Coach Fickell, Coach Ash, and I think this was the, you know, everybody's waiting for the silver bullets to come back, including the head coach, and that was a fantastic effort.
Way out here on the left.
Urban, you talked a lot this week about how far Cardale has come in 3 years. Now that he's done this, can you answer that again?
Yeah, he's one of the most improved players I've ever been around, And the correlation between handling your business off the field and on the field, he does a good job in the classroom now. I mean, it wasn't pleasant his first year here. And our academic people have done a great job. But you have to give credit to Cardale's support group at home. Obviously, he played for one of the best high school coaches in the history of the high school game, and Coach Ginn, and he's been very supportive. We've had many, many conversations with him about this situation. And if everybody wasn't aligned, that wouldn't be the same young man sitting right there. So his support group at home, his high school coach, obviously his position coach, they're all very close, and obviously Cardale bought in.